Michael Moore is a former boxing champion, but these days he's Freddie Roach's right-hand man at the Wildcard Boxing Club in Hollywood. And in fact, when Manny Pacquiao just started training for the Ricky Hatton fight, it was Michael who trained him, because Freddie was in London working with another fighter. I caught up with him for an exclusive interview.
You were an outstanding boxer. You took out Holyfield. How did you do that?
Proper training, dedication, and commitment.
Your two arms are like two Scud missiles. How do you get so good?
Just having the people, the right trainers behind me, the power that I possess, and just the fundamentals that I was taught as a young kid.
What do you say about the Manny Pacquiao, Ricky Hatton fight that's coming up? What's your take on it?
Of course Manny's gonna win. Manny's a better fighter than he is, than Ricky Hatton.
You achieved something in boxing that very few people do. You are a champion. What would you tell young kids who want to follow in your footsteps? What does it take to get there?
Well, they just gotta have, you can't teach discipline. Well, you could teach discipline, but you can't teach, you know, being a strong-minded person. I'm very strong-minded. Over the years, I've become stronger. If you want to do something, put your mind to do it, and do it.
And these days, Freddie told me you're his number one guy here. You help out. How did that happen?
I gave him a call one day. I wanted to stick in boxing. And I had gave a call out here, and I asked Freddie if I could be his assistant. And he said, yeah, sure. He didn't think I was coming because he knows I don't like California.
Where are you from?
I live in Florida.
Okay.
And I showed up. I said, the hell with it. I showed up one day, and that was it. I started work that first day.
And how's it going so far? I see it's hectic.
Well, it's not hectic to me. I handled situations like this before. But I love what I do. I love coming to work.
We're getting ready to start bringing you guys in. We want to bring you five at a time. We're going to try to expedite everything very quickly because there's a lot of people here.
Working for a good man like Freddie Roach.
How did you get into boxing in the first place? I mean, many kids play basketball, football.
My grandfather was a local trainer from my hometown of Manassas, Pennsylvania. He was in this town over, Charleroi, and being that I was around him, I would do yard work, garden work, and I would always see him leaving at a certain time. Once he left, I would always ask, could I go with him? He would say no, and one day he said yes, and I went, and the rest is history, as they say.
Two more quick ones. At what point, after you beat Holyfield, did your life change and all of a sudden you were in the cover of the magazines and the TV, and did that change at all?
I mean, it was part of the game, but it didn't change.
There's a fighter in New York named Dimitri Salida. He's 27-0, junior welterweight. He's having a tough time getting a quality fight. What does it take for a fighter like that to get someone?
Well, he has to have the right people behind him that's going to make him fight the right people. You fight the right people, he'll be up there. He'll be able to get a title shot and have some good fights under his belt.
And with Manny's fight just being a few weeks away, I could tell you this much. It's going to be exciting. In Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.